Lead code question, transpose a matrix. Question says, given a matrix A, return the transpose of A. So essentially, the transpose of a matrix is when you turn the rows to columns and the columns to rows. So like here, 2, 4, 1 row becomes 2, 4, 1 column. Minus 10, 5, 11 row becomes minus 10, 5, 11 column. 18 minus 7, 6 row becomes 18. And this is supposed to be 18, not negative. 18 minus 7, 6. Okay. So we have to turn the rows into column. So let's see how we can do this surface problem. Essentially, what I discovered is that if the number of rows is equal to the number of columns, we can just do it in place. But if you have samples where the number of rows is not equal to the number of columns, it's a bit difficult to do it in place. So for that, we need to create a new matrix. So let's go by the approach of creating a new matrix. So the new matrix that we want to create, let's call it B. And what we will do is, I always like to handle this case as a kind of program. So our base case here is if there is no matrix at all, then there's nothing to transpose. We just return it. So that's our base case there. What we do here now is we create a placeholder for the matrix that we want to return, and to do that we can set it to an infinite number in Python and create a list of that for a length and range of the length of A. That's for each of the rows. And we repeat the same list for each of the columns. This is essentially list comprehension. So length of A. Okay, so we have that. So what we will now do is that we will now look to our original array number A. We look to that both the rows and the column range number B, number A, which is the first row, to give us the number of columns. And interesting thing here is that in B, column, we swap that row, we will put A row column. We put A row column. By the time we do this, we return B, and that we do what we want. So let's use an example to see that and do a walkthrough based on an example. So we have the example here. So I'm going to use this. plus for matrix properly. Right. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so our matrix, okay, if not A, so we are able to catch an error there because we are doing a walkthrough. So that is the essence of doing a walkthrough. So if not A, we return A. And then, so we initialize B to match this. And we start with our row. So our row is 0. Our column is also 0. So what happens here is, you will discover that, let me copy this power B. So this is our B. We have initialized our B to say an infinity. Let me just use so each of our B is infinity. Okay. So we have all this initialized to infinity. This is infinity. This is infinity. This is infinity. Infinity. But doing this, because it's essential, we do a walkthrough during the interview process. And this is to help us to be used to doing a walkthrough. So our row is 0, our column is 0. So here, B00, which is this, we take on A00, which is this. So this one will become 1. So we go back, our column will become 1. So we have a 0, 1. So because we are now moving column wise down, we are moving down. So this will now be column is 0. You have not changed your column. So column is 0. Now here, we are saying that 0, 1. So we are moving down the rows. Okay? So we have swapped that. So this is 2. So this will be 2. You get the gist. See the swapping? Then, next this becomes 2. So it will become 2, 0. So this is 2, 0. So this will be 0, 2. This is 3. So it continues like that. This one becomes 1. And this becomes 0. You get a gist. So it becomes 1, 0. So here, the 1, 0. This is column 1, row 0. It is 1, 0, row 1, column 0, 4. So I'll just continue very fast. So we have 1, 1. This is 1, 1. Then we have 1, 2. This is 1, 2, row 1, column 2. Will be 1, 2, column 1, row 2, it will be this. Then it goes again, this one becomes 0, 2, so it's 0, and it becomes 2. So this is 2, 0, row 2, this. will become 0, 2, colon 0. So 2, 0, that is 7, we go 2, column 0, then we have 0, 2, so this is column 0, happened there. Okay. So if you follow that, this will be column this is column 0, row 2. So that should match this one. That should match this. Okay. So essentially, what's happening here is this first place is the row of B, but we have swapped it by specifying the column of A. So when I say 2, 0, so this is so this is 0. 2. I'm going to bear that this is 2, 0. So this is row 2. This is row 2. Column 0. There is 2, 0. This is column 2. Yeah. 0, 1, 2, this is column 2, all the, and the row is 0, 7, yeah, and 2, 1, this is 2, 1, this is row 2, column 1, and 2, 1 there, this is column 2, row 1, then we have 2, 2, which is here in A, it is row 2, column 2, but in B, it is column 2, row 2. Yeah, that's essentially that. There are some tricks there running through that, but those are the challenges we face in an introduction. So let's run it. And let's compile it. Okay, so thank you for listening. See you in the next one. Thank you.